Hi there, today on Typical Books is just a quick little reading catch-up. I had finished reading Notice, and I believe I'd mentioned this previously. It was great, you know, I really enjoyed it. And I'm glad that I finally did get my hands on a copy. I think this will be one I revisit much later and reread as an even older adult. I think it would have really fit in when I was in my 20s or whatever, looking for more transgressive literature and stumbling upon some of like Clive Barker even, Poppy C. Bright, and of course Kathy Koja, and some other books that I'm still on the hunt for that I read around that time. Yeah, I wish I could have gotten the vintage cover that has the girl photographed from the back, but this will do. This will do nicely. Glad it's in print again. Then if you've seen on my Instagram, I went into The Night Church by Whitley Strieber, really enjoying it. This is that curious copy that is signed by somebody, very strange, but a really gorgeous and fairly well kept up copy. It did have a sticker that I removed, luckily, because it was covering maybe a pivotal cover of the stained glass. I won't know yet because I had to set it down. It was just going all over the place. And I think what I wanted was Rosemary's Baby, and I was getting something different. I've watched Rosemary's Baby and I'll read it and then I'll return to The Night Church so that I've like kind of satiated that need. But yeah, I've put it down for the meantime. I wouldn't call it a did not finish because I'm just putting it on pause for now, but it's kind of a DNF. Enjoyable writing, but the story itself just took too many directions at once. But I will say The Night Church is not for the faint of heart. So I put down Night Church, immediately picked up Disappearance at Devil's Rock by Paul Tremblay, and mixed reviews aside, I loved this. I absolutely loved it. And it was a total right turn from The Night Church. I really needed to read this at that time, I guess, because it just fit in. It fit in with TV I was watching, it fit in with news, fit in with some true crime stuff that's been on my mind. Really enjoyed this. I highly recommend this if you've been reading other reviews and think, meh, I'll maybe stick to other things. If you've read Survivor Song and really like that tone, even though it's not necessarily told in text messages, is told in diary entries here and there. It's not all diary entries either. I did have a hard time and needed my glasses to read the diary entries though, so I will say if you are, you know, get a little bit slowed down by different text in books, this one might do that to you too. And last but not least, what I'm reading now, Cannibals by Guyon Smith. I was taken aback by how good of a writer Guyon Smith is. And I shouldn't have been, because I do know he has a lot of writing under his belt and he wrote for a very long time and he was published as a young teen. So yeah, it shouldn't surprise me, but I mean, I think it's the cover that makes me think, and crabs, makes me think like it's gotta be hokey jokey, but no, it's serious as a heart attack and I am loving this so far. Have you read any Guyon Smith? Did you get through The Night Church and love it? Or have you read a lot of Paul Tremblay? Let me know in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching and have an ooky, spooky day.